Nice to see you again, Tom. How are you today?
I'm okay.
So I understand that since I was seeing you that while ago, that you're in hospital again.
Yeah.
So can you tell me a bit more about what happened before that?
Well, it was a few months ago now. Yeah, I'd done quite well for a number of years. Sort of kept it under control, really. But
yeah, I mean, I've not seen you since your gap year, wasn't it?
Yeah, so that was 4 years ago. And so yeah, it was quite disappointing to go through it all again. But it sort of started towards the end of university. So I was doing law, and I was on course for a first, and I was just coming up to my final exams, mm-hmm. and I had a few essays and a few exams, and so I started working really hard. I felt like, right, now is the real time to put the effort in and to put the work in. So mm-hmm. I started to step a bit later, take on a bit more work. So my stress levels sort of start to increase over a while. I was drinking a lot more coffee, took a few caffeine tablets, energy drinks, a few people. Well, because sort of the environment at the time was a lot of people were pushing themselves that they wouldn't normally mm-hmm. do. And some people were taking Ritalin.
Oh, wow, okay.
Yeah. Which, and...
Did you take any Ritalin?
Yeah. Because it was just like, that was necessary at the time. And
how did that affect you?
Well, it sort of increased my confidence at the time. Everything that was going on, I was becoming a lot more productive. Yeah, a lot more confident, a lot. Mm-hmm. I was working harder, my brain was working faster. And so my momentum was building up and up throughout the period. And so I was relishing it, and I was doing a lot of work. And
so, what did that mean to you then to be at that time? Because it sounds like you put quite a lot of pressure on yourself. You've been doing really well at uni, and you know, this was it. This was the time. What did it mean to you to be feeling like that, kind of more awake and more energised, maybe?
Yeah, well, for me, it was my sort of time. So I'd spent 3 years. I was in control. I was doing well. It wasn't really part of my life at the time. I didn't really talk to any of my friends about it. But then I started to just sort of grow into it. And I took the opportunity to, enjoy this time. And it didn't really reach its peak until after my exams. I was still functioning throughout my exams. I have since found out that I didn't get the results that I wanted to.
Mm-hmm. Why do you think that was?
I thought that I was working harder than ever, but it was misjudged, I think. And so I didn't perform to the best of my ability when it came to the exams. And so I didn't achieve a first try. I only got 2-1.
What else was happening for you around that time? I mean, you talked about the pressure of your exams and staying up for them. Was anything else going on for you around the same time?
Well, so it was the end of university, and that was the time where, as soon as that period stopped of work, then I was sort of let off the leash a bit. And yeah, I just sort of to grow even further. So I mentioned I was was taking Ritalin, drinking a lot of coffee, and as soon as like exams had stopped, I just substance abuse sort of took a bit more of a hold. And yeah, I just sort of grew into this person who I thought was him, was the guy that everyone wanted to be around and to see. And so I made sure that I was just everywhere that could be seen. I was,
So this is like the gap after you finish the exams, but before the results are out,
weeks. So we were just, I was going out a lot, if not every night.
You said that you were taking Ritalin and drinking a lot of coffee.
Yeah.
And using other drugs as well.
Yeah, it sort of developed into cocaine, a lot of cocaine, MDMA, MCAT.
And how did they affect you?
I honestly was on cloud nine at the time. I was the person that everyone wanted to know. In my head, I put myself at the center of the universe, and I convinced a friend of mine who develops apps that we should. I had an idea to develop an app about when you go into a alcohol shop, that it all weigh up, but like, what's the most cost effective way to get wasted?
Right.
So at the time I was spending a lot of money, a lot of my parents' savings. I'd got a credit card, which I didn't tell them about. Mm-hmm. And so in this sort of role as the man about town, I was spent a lot on alcohol, drugs, clothes. I invested in this technology. I was...
So it sounds like it began with kind of the exam pressure and putting more pressure on yourself to stay up, using kind of stimulants to keep yourself awake. And then you started to feel like you were more and more the man.
Mm.
You were kind of popular, you were successful. How did you respond and cope with those symptoms? What did you do once those are kind of begun?
Well, having not had to deal with my illness throughout university and for it not being a part of that world, I didn't confront those symptoms in a way that's gonna have long-term sort of stability. It began with doing the work that I needed to do. That's just what I needed to do in order to achieve my goals and to achieve what I want to. And then I just let it take hold, and it was all part of me. It wasn't the illness, it was me. It was just, I was the master of this whole situation, and everything that was happening was down to my own doing.
So it sounds, you say on the one hand you didn't confront it, you kind of just let it roll. And on the other hand, you said that you kind of took it as evidence that you were very energetic, you were powerful. This was all kind of explained about who you were. And it, I guess, how did that affect you, looking at things in that way?
It just... It was my time. It had all been leading to this was the moment where I would sort of, like, become the person that I wanted to be. Mm-hmm. All the hard work, all the work that my parents had done for me, all the work that I'd been doing, it was now crystallising.
Mm-hmm. It felt like you were on the brink of something enormous from the sounds of it. Again, going back to that kind of beginning stage where you started to stay up late and use stimulants, I mean, how much sleep were you getting at the beginning?
It gradually diminished, I think. It began at 6, 5, and then ended up about 3 and 2 hours.
And what kind of things did you notice? Did you notice any changes from having less and less sleep in your body, maybe, or the way you were thinking?
I think the harder I was working, the faster my brain then would work, and the harder I worked, the more I would do. So the momentum was building more than anything, and my thoughts were firing and my goals were stronger and my determination was bigger.
And how did you feel in your body? Did you notice any changes physically?
Not that I can recall. At the time, maybe I was avoiding confronting any negative effects, but nothing powerful comes to mind.
Okay. And once you'd kind of things were a bit further along after your exams, you said you were going out a lot, you convinced your friend to do this app. Was there anything else that you did that maybe you wouldn't normally do that you think might have been assigned to you that your mood was much higher than you'd like it to be?
I had a lot of savings that my parents had built up for me, which don't really exist anymore, either through the money I invested, and through drugs, clothes. I had a girlfriend at the time, but because I was the main character in a sense, that I was only really the person that mattered, and so sort of those around me, especially her, just sort of didn't really have as much importance. So on nights out, she just wouldn't be in my mind, and so there would be other women.
Okay.
So.
And how do you feel about that now, looking back on it?
I think it's those moments where it's not just me, it's those closest to you and those around you that have to suffer them more than anyone else, that brings a lot of the shame.